Hello students, how are you all? How are your studies going on? I hope you are doing good. Students, I am going to a prose, that prose 3, Gentleman of Rio and Medio. Before going to the lesson, I would like to say few things about the lesson, children. The lesson tells us the human relation with the land and his descendants. So this is the main thing here. Now when I go, just imagine, you can see here before you read, imagine your grandfather owns a small piece of land abundant with fruit yielding trees. It is inherited from his ancestors. Your father intends to sell it. What would be the reaction of your grandfather? Complete the dialogue between your father and your grandfather. Now, for example, father, could we sell the land? Grandfather, keep silent for a few seconds. No, we should not. It is inherited from my ancestors. Father, so what? Grandfather, it is my prized possession. Father, but it is old. Now, four blanks are given there. So now, we can continue with the conversation here. So what does grandfather says here? Father says, but it is old. So grandfather says, so what? Old is gold. Again father says, it is of no use to us. Why grandfather again he says, that is true. But if we keep it, your son will inherit and may use it for something. So now father had to agree with grandfather. He said, okay father. Now here children, as I said you all, the introduction, this lesson tells us about a true incident. It's about Don Anselmo, who lived in Rio and Medio. He had wished to sell his land. The land was bought by the Americans for just $1,200. He sold his land and house to them. The Americans replastered the house, pruned the trees, and repaired the fence. Very soon, the local children ran through the territory. That's when the Americans came to know that Don Anselmo had not sold the fruit-bearing trees. They belonged to the people of Rio and Medio. This lesson tells us about the importance of preserving land. One must take care of trees to preserve the environment. This is the introduction of the lesson. And now, when I go to, before reading the lesson, now I would like to read about the author also, children. So, Juan A.A. Cedillo, he was born in the year of 1902. And he was up to 1982, was born in New Mexico. Where was he born? He was born in New Mexico. He worked as a lawyer and held public office. He wrote about Mexico and southwestern United States. The given story is based on an actual legal case, what we see in and around us nowadays. Understood? Now, I'll read with the lesson, children. Gentlemen of Rio and Medio. This lesson is written by Juan A.A. Cedillo. It took months of negotiation to come to an understanding with the old man. He was in no hurry. What he had the most of was time. He lived up in Rio and Medio, where his people had been for hundreds of years. He tilled the same land they had tilled. His house was small and wretched, but quaint. The little creek ran through his land. His orchard was gnarled and beautiful. So what happened, children? Here there lived an old man, that too named as Don Anselmo. And here he lived up the mountains in Rio and Medio, and Spanish for river in between, where his people had lived for eons. And now what happened here? It took some months of negotiation. Negotiation means it is a official discussion. We can say it as a official discussion to come to an understanding with the old man. So there was an official discussion to come to an understanding with the old man. Whereas the old man was not in a hurry to sell his property. And most of the thing is, he had lot of time. He was not in a hurry to sell the property. He had lot of time also. Here, he lived up in Rio and Medio, where his people had been for hundreds of years. So, as I told you all, where his people had lived for eons. Okay? What did he do? He tilled the same land his ancestors had tilled. Tilled means, you know, no? So, here, tilled in the sense to cultivate. Okay. So, what his ancestors did, the same way he had to till the land. His house was small and wretched. So, what happened here? His house was small and wretched. The house was not pleasant to him. It was unpleasant. And quaint means here, unusual and attractive, especially in an old-fashioned way. In that way, the house was there. And there was a little creek. Little creek in the sense, a small narrow stream or a river which was running in that land. And his house was small. As I said, y'all, his orchard was gnarled and beautiful. So, what was his orchard? Orchard in the sense, a piece of land in which fruit trees are grown, gnarled, where the branches or the branch of a tree with twisted with hard lumps, that is called as gnarled. Got it, children? Now shall we go to the next page? Here you can see this. The day of the sale, he came into the office. His coat was old, green and faded. I thought of Senator Catron, who has been such a power with these people up there in the mountains. Perhaps it was one of his old Prince Alberts. He wore gloves. They were old and torn, and his fingertips showed through them. He carried a cane, but it was only the skeleton of a worn-out umbrella. Behind him walked one of his innumerable kin, a dark young man with eyes like a gazelle. So what happened here? After months of negotiation, what did he do? He had to sell his property. So the negotiation was, he had to sell his property. And what did he do? Here, the day came of the sale. He came to the office. To whose office he came? He came to the office of Juan A. Cedillo. He had hold an old coat. So, the old man, you might have seen the old people, they are wearing an old coat. And it was green in color, but totally it was faded. I thought of Senator Catron. So, whom do we call as Senator Catron here, children? So, Thomas Benton Catron, a senior from New Mexico, who ruled from 1912 to 1917. So, when the old man came, all could feel that He is like Senator Catron, who has been such a power with this people up there in the mountains. So when the old man came to the office, everyone they felt that he is such a powerful person who is leading his life with his descendants in the mountains. Perhaps it was one of his old Prince Albert's. So Prince Albert's means long double breast coat. One who wears such a long double breast coat. He wore gloves also. They were old and torn, and his fingertips showed through them. So he was wearing a gloves to his hand, and it was old enough. It was ragged and torn. His fingertips were coming out or peeping through them. He carried a cane. So cane means, you know, what do you mean by a cane? That is a stick. Understood? That too, it was like a only skeleton of a worn out umbrella. It was a skeleton of a worn out umbrella. Worn out umbrella means, you know, no? Behind him walked one of his innumerable kin, a dark young man with eyes like a gazelle. So behind him who walked is one of his relative. Innumerable kin means one of his relative who was behind this old man. He was dark in complexion and his eyes was like a gazelle. So children, up to here I'll end the lesson. So in my next class I'm going to explain the rest.